The United States this morning believes it has taken out a major terrorist threat in Syria. Airstrikes probably killed a key bomb maker linked to Al Qaeda. It was part of American attacks targeting militants like the Khorasan group. Some intelligence officials believe it poses a greater threat to the United States than ISIS. Bob Orr is in Washington with the significance of this attack. Bob, good morning.
Well, good morning. These airstrikes certainly appear to be a significant blow against a very dangerous terrorist cell and may have disrupted plots ongoing against Europe and the homeland. U.S. aircraft have taken out some of Khorasan's bomb-making facilities and very likely one of the group's most lethal operatives.
The target was this man, 24-year-old David Drugeon. A French-born convert to Islam, Drugeon is described as one of Al Qaeda's top bomb-makers. Officials believe Drugeon was riding in this car in Syria on Wednesday when the vehicle was destroyed by missiles fired by a U.S. military Reaper drone. While officials have no conclusive proof, such as DNA, that Drugeon is dead, they say the airstrikes were successful in taking out the intended targets. In a statement, the U.S. Central Command said, quote, "We are still assessing the outcome of the attack, but we have initial indications that it resulted in the intended effects by striking terrorists." The drone strike was part of a wider assault against Drugeon's al-Qaeda-linked terrorist cell called the Khorasan Group. B-1 bombers and F-16 aircraft destroyed a number of buildings in northwest Syria, believed to house the group's bomb-making and terror training facilities. Comprised of hardcore al-Qaeda veterans, Khorasan has been exploiting the lawlessness of Syria to develop hard-to-detect non-metallic bombs, explosive devices that can be smuggled aboard airliners hidden in shoes, clothing, cell phones, and even human bodies. In recent months, U.S. intelligence has suggested that Khorasan was inching closer to launching attacks on targets in both Europe and the United States. In response, security on U.S.-bound international flights has been tightened.
Now, Wednesday's airstrikes mark the second time the U.S. has attacked Khorasan inside Syria since September. Although officials say this wave resulted in considerably more damage than the first, they also warn it would be naive at this point to think that the Khorasan threat has been entirely eliminated. Nora?
All right, Bob, thank you so much.